welcome to Hat in Hand and another episode of Coffee and Canvas. I'm Kevin, and today we've got another black canvas here. I've got a thin coat of liquid clear on there, and it's all slicked up and ready to go. And so a couple episodes ago, I did that fun little space scene with the planets and the gaseous clouds and stuff, and it was really colorful and a whole lot of fun. And I thought today maybe try to do like a little alien world or something, and got a few crazy ideas up in my mind, and we'll see if I can get to some of them to show up on the canvas today. So what we're going to do is we're going to start off with our 2-inch brush here, and we're going to get into our Alizarin Crimson. Oh yeah. Don't need a whole lot. You'll see why. So we're gonna do a sun, but we're gonna do a red sun, which that'll be pretty interesting. Since it's an alien world, not every solar system has a yellow sun like we have, so some of them have a red sun or a crimson sun. So we're gonna use our 2-inch brush to make a crimson sun. All right, and that's put this guy right here. So what I'm gonna do is I'm just touching it right here, and I'm gonna rotate a nice little spot there. Kind of visible a little bit, but that's okay. It's gonna be real bright anyway. So, and then while we have our brush, it's still a little dirty, let's go into our Prussian blue. Well, I got a couple new colors on here. I forgot, before I get too far, I forgot to tell you what colors I'm using today, and I got some new ones I'm gonna try out, so I added them to the palette. So I got a nice loaded up variety of colors to play with today. So I got my standard titanium white, phthalo green, phthalo blue, some Prussian blue, got some midnight black, got a little bit of Van Dyke brown, some dark sienna, alizarin crimson, got some sap green on here. I'm also using some cadmium yellow, Indian yellow. I've got a new one, it's called Dusty Rose. It's kind of a pinkish color. Got some magenta, some mauve, and bright red. So I got all sorts of variety, and hopefully this ends up being nice, bright, and colorful. So let's see what else we can come up with. So let's get into our Prussian blue. Now that blue will overpower that red. So sorry, and it ends up being a little purple. That's fine too. We're not too worried about it. It's an alien world, so crazy things can happen. So, all right. So let's kind of go around our sun here with this blue here we could put on here. So I'm just gonna go up right here, right above that red spot, and I'm gonna press in, swipe out. I'm gonna go on the underside, press in, swipe out. I'm gonna flip it over. I do the same thing on the other side. Press in, swipe out. Press in, swipe out. clean this brush, and we'll get into our next set of colors. All right, now I got nice. And I got a nice clean dry brush here, and let's get into. Let's get into the Indian yellow. We're gonna get into all sorts of colors today. It'll either be really cool or it'll be a complete disaster. But I have a feeling it's gonna be pretty cool. So let's this yellow here. Let's just kind of go for. This is what we're gonna be our horizon line, I guess. So maybe starting right around here. We'll just put a nice little stripe across the. Back into this yellow a little bit more. There we go. Alright. Now let's get into the phthalo green. Like I said, we're going to use all sorts of color. You can't see it yet, but when we start adding the white, it's just going to come alive. And it's going to be a sight to behold. I think. Alright, so we got some phthalo green on our brush here. Let's start up in this corner right up here. We'll just do some eczema. It's like we're doing a normal sky, but instead of blue, we're using phthalo green. Clean this brush and we'll get to the next step. Oh wait, before I get too far, I'm gonna add a little bit of sap green to this. And then I'm just gonna put a little spot right down here. Clean this brush. Alright. Better be careful, the mob might run right off my palette here. Alright. Let's see here. Let's go with our two-inch brush here. Okay, we're gonna get into our titanium white. We've got a fair amount on here. Not too much, though. And we're gonna start by doing a little X patterns. We're gonna start where our sun is, and then we're gonna work our way around and work our way out. And now it's important that we don't go back to the middle, because we don't want to get our dirty colors back in the sun here. We want to make sure that stays nice and bright. So by doing that, we start, or how we do that, we start from the sun, work our way out, and if we want it brighter, we just keep adding white paint. But it's very important that in between applications of adding more white, you gotta wash your brush or use a clean brush every time, because like I said, you don't want to bring in the dirty paint back into where your sun is, and it starts getting dull and not looking right. So we'll start right over here where our sun is, and this is where it gets really fun. The colors are really going to start popping out here. It's going to be pretty amazing. All right, so here we go. We're going to start by going right here. For a second, take a dry brush here, and we're going to go back over it nice and lightly. I'll work some of those brush strokes out. Kind of start blending it together. A little too much white there. I'll take this one. All right, wash the brushes. Alright, this time I'm gonna use the 1-inch brush. Get into the back into the titanium white. Alright. Get this brighter. Brighten this up a bit. Okay, so That's taking too long. Go back to our 2-inch brush. Go back over one more time. Okay. I'm gonna take a nice clean dry brush and I'm gonna go time to clean the brushes again. now that little spot there is a little too white, so I wanted red. So I'm gonna get it into get a little dab of bright red on my fingertip. I'm just going to put a little Okay, well, maybe it's more of an orange sun. Still looks pretty cool, though, I think. It's our world. If we want an orange sun, we can have an orange sun. I still think it looks kind of cool. So. Alright, let's knock off some of the excess there. Okay. I do wish that was a little brighter, though. That's okay. Maybe. Sorry, I think that'll be fine, just the way it is. Okay, so take another sip. Yeah, that works. So, maybe in our little sky here, maybe we're on a moon and we're orbiting a planet. So maybe we'll have a planet with a moon. We'll see what it looks like when we're done. We'll decide then. But I'm going to take my filbert brush, and I got this little lid for, it's from something. But anyway, it looks like a pretty good size, and we'll make a nice little satellite to orbit around. So I'm going to get into, let's get into the dusty rose. I think that's still one. Let's get a little dab, just a little touch, don't need much, of some liquid white. Okay, let's figure out where we want to put our satellite, planet, mountain. Now, maybe this is like we won't see all of the planet or what have you. Maybe like a crescent shape or something, you know, so we'll just see part of it. It's where the sun's shining off of. That'd be kind of a neat effect. So maybe we'll have it right. Started. Back into this dusky rose. Let's stand up. Free-handed best I can. All that down for now. I'm gonna get into the bit with my bigger filbert brush and get some liquid white on there. And let's get into the, how about, let's get into magenta. That'd be pretty. Here we go. Really load that brush up with that magenta. Well, that's not working. Okay. Plan B. Alright, I'm going to set that down for a second while I figure this out. Use the bigger knife. back into titanium white and dusty rose. Now, let's see if we can get this to. Oh, I hear you, Kitty. I hear you. Let's get some. Let's soften that edge up a little bit. Just going to kind of tap the edges a little bit, kind of soften them up so that way they look like they're fading into the sky. Gotta very lightly gotta go over this a little bit. We don't want to have extreme detail, soften the space. There we go. Whew. Well, I reckon that's pretty neat looking. It'd be really neat from where I'm sitting. Alright. Wouldn't mind if that was just a little bit brighter. Know what to do to make it brighter. Probably a little too late now. That's alright. Maybe I'll put some stuff up there. Alright, so let's get crazy here. Let's go ahead and get our fan brush. Take a little sip of coffee. Okay, so let's go ahead and get some bright red on our fan brush. And using the corner, we're making some little bushy guys here. take our little liner brush here. Let's get a little paint thinner on there, and let's go into our Van Dyke brown. Kind of put a few little indications of some tree guys back over here. Got it nice and thin. Come back to some more of those. Now maybe we had ourselves a little bit of reflection down here. Let's figure out where we want our reflection of water line to be. Let's see here. Maybe it's not water, it might be methane, I don't know. Green. Let's see, let's start off, let's grab there, pull straight down. Straight down. Nice little reflections there. Okay, now let's get back to our knife here for a second. Clean it off real quick. Now let's just bring a little bit of this liquid white up here on the think that's starting to look like something. I think the kitty's starting to improve. Alright, I'll be right back. I'm gonna get some more coffee and we'll see where this painting takes us next. Got a fresh cup of coffee. Cat's a little annoyed with me because I'm not paying attention to her. But that's okay. It won't be too much longer. But alright, so got some fresh coffee. And I think it's time to start filling in some of this other stuff here. And so let's see here. Before we get too far, getting indecisive. Okay, so let's get a little dab of liquid white on our 1-inch brush here. And let's go ahead and get into, oh well, shoot, this makes us crazy. Let's get into some phthalo blue. Okay. Maybe over here. Got some little bushies. That's pretty wild looking. Maybe we'll stick with that theme a little bit. Add a little Prussian blue. Move them over on this side. We got get with our, let's take our number 10 filbert brush and let's get a little dab of titanium white. Ooh, let's get into the mauve here. This ought to be interesting. And maybe bit of a guy, right. Another one. get our smaller filter brush here. Take a little dab of liquid white. Get some dusty rose on here. And we'll just highlight the edges of this. So, just like that. Okay, let's get into our fan brush and get a little liquid white on it. Get into the cadmium. We'll get into the cadmium yellow. Now, what's nice about these black canvases is it does a lot of the dark color back behind it, so you can just kind of go straight into the colors. So let's put a little bit of grassy stuff underneath this guy here. I'm just going to be pressing down on the fan brush here. Guy back down, get a little bit of this blue back into this phthalo blue. Okay, let's see. A little dab there. Fix that. I don't really like the way that turned out, but that's okay. I can fix it. Come back to it. Let's see. Let's do another one of those cool flowers. I kind of like that. Let's get back into our mauve here. A little bit of titanium white. Some mauve. Maybe. Another one of those guys. Now let's take our, got another fan brush here. Go ahead and add a little bit of dirt here. Let's get into our, let's take some Van Dyke Brown. With some dark sienna. And we're just gonna put in a little bit of dirt right here. Probably put some other stuff in there too, but let's get a little base coat of brown in there just for some dirts. And it's okay, they don't really see it that well right now. It'll come up more as we put some highlights and some other stuff in there. We're not wanting it to be overbearing. So maybe, maybe over on this side, get ourselves a nice little well, let's see, let's get ourselves a nice looking tree here. How about we use, oh, let's not use a liner brush, let's use something bigger. Okay. Oh, I know, I'm not paying attention. Okay, so let's take some Van Dyke Brown and make ourselves a little tree right over here. How about that? That sounds pretty good. Maybe this guy is right. Maybe it'll be a nice crooked tree. Start there and wipe that off. And let's take our liner brush, get back in, get a little bit thinner on it. And let's go ahead and put some branches on this guy. Now, let's put a few leaves on there. Let's take our oval brush, dip it in some liquid white, and how about we go into, just set apart from that. Let's go into the crimson. Ooh, yeah. Maybe we got some that's pretty cool looking. Let's get back into our little blue here. Maybe we got some. That'll be good. Now maybe we can get into let's see here, how about oh, this has got all sorts of color in it. Well, let's go ahead and make some more of those guys. I like those. Those are neat. Okay, let's get into the mauve. Yeah. Maybe we got a nice big one that starts like right up here.
highlight action with the dusty rose.
I think it's time for me to clean some brushes. I'm kind of running out of clean ones to use, so that'll give me a chance to figure out what I'm going to do next, too. So, give me just a second. Alright, I think probably should put a little bit of highlight on that tree there. I just realized I kind of forgot to do that, so go ahead and do that real quick. So, I'm going to take a little bit of this dark sienna. Oh, I got a little bit of this little mix of weird colors over here with my titanium white. I'll just throw those in there too. Oh, that's neat. Go ahead and cut across that. And we'll just put a few highlights in. Need a whole lot, just a little bit. Oh yeah, that really made it pop. All right, let's go ahead and wipe this knife off real quick and figure out where we want to go from here. Maybe we got some other bushes over here. Let's go with another color. We got yellow, we got blue, we got some mauve and stuff. What haven't we used yet? Well, how about we take our fan brush here, and we're going to get into some of this titanium white. We'll get into this dusty rose here. Gotta be able to have a little beach area to set up a picnic, you know?
And don't kill all your dark areas, those are important. Kinda gives you a little bit of texture, depth. I like that. I like that a lot. There we go. There we go. I like that. That's cool.
Okay, set that back down. And I need to put some bushes over here to kind of fill that out. Let's go with our 1-inch brush again. And get a little dab of liquid white on it. And maybe this time,
I know, Kitty.
Well, let's just go ahead and get into this phthalo green, or I'm sorry, the sap green, and along with some along with some cadmium yellow. Oh, one more sap green. And maybe a little touch of phthalo blue. There we go.
Maybe this guy goes. These guys would be right. Not Kitty. Oh, oops.
All right. Let's go back to our fan brush. It had the dust, a little bit more dusty rose on there.
We're going to kind of go back over this a little bit. Kind of blend that in with that green here.
It almost feels like there's something missing over there. I think
Well, I hear you. I hear you.
Oh, well, how about we put another tree in here? Let's go ahead and maybe this guy.
Well, I don't know.
Hi, Kitty. Kitty's not happy with me. I'm not paying attention to her.
Okay, maybe we'll have a here's some indications. Oh, she's really carrying on today. I'll better hurry up before she gets too mad at me. Alright, go ahead. Thank you.
get some back into some highlight color. Maybe, there it is.
Okay. A little bit of highlight on this guy. I'm gonna run this.
I think I better stop there before I get too carried away and mess it all up. I think I probably should have stopped before that tree, but I still think it looks pretty cool. And so I think with that, we have a finished painting. Hope you enjoyed our little experiment today. And if you did, feel free to subscribe. You know you want to. So just go ahead and do it. Feels good. Anyway, till next time, be good to each other, and remember, be creative.